Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing Planet. And a couple of hours ago they invited me to the beta, so I can show you guys the motorboat update. You guys can see it here and what you are going to get, because it's not only boats. I'm not getting everything in one video, so I'm going to make a couple of videos if it's going live, because I think it's coming this week already. A lot of people thought it was today, but I think it's coming this week. Of course, I'm going to make live videos of the live update, of course. The beauty about the beta is that I can buy everything, because I got a shitload of money, and I'm going to show you guys every type of boat. I'm going to show you guys the new lures in this video, and we are going to fish a little bit. But first of all, what is incoming in this update? You guys can see it. Three new types of boats: metal, rubber and motor boats, and bass boats. You guys can see it. Two new sets of missions: exploration and mastery. I will show you guys that in the next video with the competitions, because you can make your own competition now too. That's really cool, because I didn't know that. The new lures, the jerkbait and the minnows. So the jerkbaits, they are for pike, muskie. The minnows are deep wobblers for catfish and all that stuff. So I already was thinking about getting two wobblers, very deep ones, and just go to Germany and drag out a hole in the middle of the lake for catfish. I think that will be really cool. I tested the trolling too, but it don't work at the moment. I'm not sure that they just disable it for a moment, because I saw Big Daddy is stream, and I just did the same, but I cannot put the rods in the rod holder. So there was a guy that asked me the question, how many rod holders there are. I cannot answer that question at the moment. I think it's disabled in the beta, but I think in the future, in the live version, they are going to get trolling. Then improved fish biting behavior. I'm not sure what it is. Then they changed access level for Emerald and Rocky Lake. Rocky Lake is now level 5, Emerald level 8, but I think it was already 8 or 7. So Rocky Lake comes now in front of Emerald. I'm not sure why they did it. Maybe they are going to put a smaller lake in between. I don't know. And then you got a DLC, a motorboat pack, but you guys need to check it out what is in it. So we are going to start now. First, I'm going to give you guys a little bit of info. So where can you get the boats? Because you don't need to buy every time a boat. You can just rent the boats too. So I need to think now for a moment, because on the previous video, I already made this video two times. So the first one is going to be Emerald Lake, New York, Oregon, Falcon Lake, White Moose Lake, St. Croix Lake, Michigan, and in California. So you guys can check it on the website too. That are the five lakes in America, I think. Maybe I forgot one, I'm not sure. Then in Europe, you can go to Tiber, you can go to Germany, and you can go to Russia. So that's Aktuba. That are the three of the five that you can use the boat. So, that's it, where you can use them. So now it's time to go to the shop, because I want to give you guys all the data. I'm not sure that it's going to change that much, the price and all that stuff, the levels. So you guys can see it here. So you got at level 14 and 20, of course. It's always the same system in this game. So if you want to get access sooner to better gear or better equipment, you need to pay bait coins. Is it needed? No, it's not needed. If you think that you want to sponsor a little bit the game, you can do it. But you just level up and you will buy it with just normal currency. So you guys can see that are the two boats. Level 14, so you can use it in Emerald. And you can use it in not Falcon. So only New York you can use this boat the moment that you buy it. Then here you got rubber boat, that's 20. At 30 you got a metal one. 34 you got a metal one. If you click on it, you can see the weight. You can see how big they are. You can see that they got an echo sonar. So this is the basic. This is advanced. Then at level 40, you can finally buy a rubber boat. So you see the horsepower too, how fast it can go. Here you can see it's a little bit more. So the further you go, the more horsepower it got. The rubber boats, they look really cool. The metal boats, yeah, they are metal boats, you know. It's just a motor on a piece of metal and you can fish from it. So, but I will show you guys it. Then you got the best boats, and that's the real stuff. So here you got the Gary Scott, and here you can already see why those two best boats are very good. So if you go fishing with the boat, you stand in front. But the main problem is you cannot see your sonar anymore. In this boat, you see the sonar here. You need to step out and you need to fish here. So I don't think there are a lot of people going to buy a boat without the sonar at the top. Because you cannot see the sonar if you're fishing. You guys will see it if we go to the lake. So this is the one, 400,000. It's very cheap in my opinion. Because you need to imagine that the 300 kilogram net is 185,000. So you pay your best boat double the net. If I got this in real life, I just bought myself 10 best boats, to be honest. Because it's very cheap. So a lot of people were expecting around the million. 1 million currency for this boat. So it's a very fair price, I need to say. So yeah, and now it's time to show you guys the new lures, and then I'm going to show you guys the boats, of course. So the new lures are this one, so jerk baits and minnows. You got a lot of them, so you guys can see it here. You can just equip them on a casting and a spinning rod. You don't need a jerk bait. So these are the jerk baits. You can see what will bite on them, I hope. Best pike and muskie. So you guys can see it here. Here are the deep runners. So you guys already, 4 meter is this one. This one is 8 meter, the white skeleton. Very beautiful one. But 60 bait coins. So walleye, pike, catfish or salmon. And then you got this one. The hunched runners that you can buy. There are a lot of them. I'm going to test them. If the trolling works again, I'm going to make a video that I troll around with them, because they are made for trolling. It's very good for trolling the wobblers. So that is a little bit all the lures that you got. That's it a little bit, I think. And I saw here that you can buy a hat, but I don't see the hat yet, so I'm not sure what you can do. So first of all, another thing that I want to say to you guys is the boats, they got durability, so you need to repair them. So I will show you guys it over here. So here are all the boats that I bought, so you can repair them. I'm not sure how much it's going to be. Here is my my boat. I parked them on Santa Claus's hut. I will show you guys it in the video too. That's the first thing that I did. But first, we are going to get the metal boat. And I'm going to show you guys it in White Moose Lake. That's Alberta. Because we are going to fish there a little bit. Because the last couple of days, I was there for the semis and the final. It was really bad. I was not prepared. I made it just in 4 seconds in the final, but I was using the wrong lure, and yeah, at the end I was 14th of the 20 people. It's still not good, but I got a little bit a mixed feeling because I was not prepared. I need to say it how it is. The other guys were a lot better prepared than me. So yeah, it's a pity, but yeah, it's how it is. So here is the boat. You need to push E. And you guys can see it. It just got the basic sonar. Here we go. So you can see how fast you go. The Celsius and the depth. So here at the moment it's 1 meter. So here is the motor. You need to start it with E. And then you are going to get the mini game. So with the left mouse button you need to keep it pushed in. And then you need to get it in the green. So that was not good. That's not good either. Yeah, that's better. And now we are gone. And you guys can see this is just basic, so I'm going to put a little bit the sound down because the sound is very high. And we are going to the trout area, and the moment that you see, let me have a look, is there fish? The sonar is working in front of the boat, so you guys can now see clearly there is no fish here. Let's go a little bit back. Nope, there is no fish. They are not really active. I'm not sure how the new system is going to work with fish finders, because at the moment we got positions, we got time frames, and is it going to change? Because I saw on the bass boat, it's a lot easier to watch it on the bass boat. There is a fish. You guys see it? At the bottom. Two lake trouts, I think. So if I throw now my rod out, I'm going to catch that fish. But I'm not going to fish from this boat. I'm going to fish from the bass boat. So now I'm going back and I'm going to get the rubber boat. So let's do this quick. So inventory, home, and then we are taking here the rubber boat, the Gary Scott, the green one. It's a very nice boat. I like the design a lot. I like the colors a lot. So you guys are going to see it's already a very good upgrade, this one. Because I think in the future, what they are going to do, I think that they are going to make the lakes bigger. Because they did it in Florida with the salty delta. So I think that's going to happen. So a lot of people are saying, yeah, but the lakes are so small. Yeah, but you can just make a lake that is already in the game just bigger, you know. So, and there is a fish in front of me. So you guys can see, this looks already a lot professional than the metal boat. And it's totally filled with fish here in front of me. I guess brook trout and perch. So we need to do the mini game again on this one. Okay, here we go. And you guys saw that this one goes to 40 kilometers an hour. I forgot to check the speed on the metal one. Let's have a look that we can find the pike here. So it's 4.5 meters here deep on the dam. So you guys can see it, 4 meters. I'm not sure that there is fish. And the problem is this. So let's put the anchor out. If you push R. Ah, here you can keep seeing the sonar. Ah, that's good. That's good. So it's only on the bass boats that you cannot see it. Let's get the... So here you guys can see it. I'm not sure. Can I walk around here in this boat? I don't think that you can walk around. It's a pity because I want to go to the front. Let's have a look. I don't think that the pike is active. Therefore, we cannot see it because they are very active on a sunny day. But I hope in the future that we can, because this is not easy fishing, you know, because if maybe the sonar is watching that direction, so maybe we need to throw over here. But I want to go a little bit further, but at the moment I don't think that you can go further. So it would be a little bit better if I can go a little bit further, because fishing like this is not so easy with all the equipment in between. No, there is no fish here, guys. Okay, that was it for the rubber boat. So now we are going to show the crème de la crème, and that is the bass boat. So with the bass boat, I'm going to fish for real on the lake trout. I'm going to fish with like a big dick setup. It's the biggest setup that you can have. It was in the, you already can use it in the game, but at the moment in the game, because it's a casting setup, a very heavy one, it's very hard to use because you cannot do the meters, but it's very good for a boat. So it's this setup, the RiverTex 30 kilograms, RiverTex Tornado 30 kilograms, Braidline 0.32, that's 30 kilograms. Normally I cannot use that because I'm going to break shit, but it's better, I can do what I want. If I break shit, it's all okay. So we are going to use this for the lake trout, and now it's time to get the very heavy equipment out. Let me have a look where it is. Here, of course. Let's go home. The Orion is the level 51. So, and now it's time to show you guys something very cool. So, the first thing that I did was this. So, Can you do a little bit a Knievel jump? Yeah, you can do that. That's I will show you guys it. I'm going to jump in Santa Claus's hut. So over here, I'm going to try to park the boat here on the campfire. It's possible. I already did it. This one is like you need to check this, how beautiful it is. So you got the sonar at the front, so you can stand here at the front. And you can watch the sonar very well. So this is the very good equipment. So let's start the engine and let's do this, guys, because this one goes so fast, it's crazy. Okay, here we go, guys. There we go. Just like this. Park like a bro. You guys see it? It's for Christmas. But the main problem is I need to travel again now. So don't do this at home. But that's the first thing that I did when I got this boat. I'm not sure that you can do it with other boats, but you need to imagine that somebody is standing now on the dock. So I don't have friends, you guys know that. I'm only lonely guy. But if I had a friend, I would put him on the dock and I just jump over him with the boat and I just record it. That would be so cool. I think in the future they are going to remove that. I'm almost sure that they are going to remove it. So now my boat is back. I just reset the area and now it's time for the real stuff. So let's get the boat out. And the sound of the boats is very high, so the audio is not equal to all the other sound in the game. Therefore, there is no sound. And the moment that I step in the boat, the sound goes very high. It's only at 1 or 2% at the moment, the audio. And I cannot fix that problem because the audio of the game is one audio channel, so you cannot filter it out. So I hope that they just make it a little bit better. Okay, I need to watch it because I'm already. Okay, let's go back. Oh, start engine. Anchor out. Okay, and there. Do you guys see the fish? It's totally filled with fish. This is a lot professional. And here you can just go to the front. It's still, and you can go around with your sonar. I'm not sure why you need to do that. Maybe just to get all the fish. But still, it's for me, it's in the way a little bit equipment. I'm not sure how you can fix that problem, but maybe the sonar need to be over here so that it looks sideways, that and that I can do like a small step in front, because that was the first thing. I getting used to it, but I think at the moment that it's not really friendly fishing, I think, because for me it's in the way. Maybe it's just my opinion, of course, but you guys see it. So yeah, now we are going to fish like a pro, you know. So we are going to get some lake trout with the 30 kilogram of test. Now you can do that. So, and there is a fish already. That's good. So I'm going to put a little bit like this. Check this. So many, it's like a school of fish. So we're just going to twitch the first meters and the lure will go down. It's very strange because I'm not sure how this comes, but my lure is sinking very, very slow. It's possible it's maybe 100 meters over there, but on my sonar it's now 9 meters. It takes a long time for 9 meters. I'm not sure how far the sonar is going. Maybe it's only 20 meters. Oh, this fish we are going to catch, guys. Check. This is mine. I'm expecting a bite. Come on, fish. It's so much fish here, and the cool thing is this is not happy hour. So that means that maybe the times are gone if you work with the sonar. Yeah, and this I don't understand either. Why my lure is not going anymore down. It's 9 meters still deep here, and I still got 60 meters. Yeah, not sure how that comes. I saw it a couple of times. Maybe they need to adjust a little bit still the depth everywhere. Because I got the impression there is an invisible bottom at the moment, so. Or my sonar is already broken, that's a possibility too. Okay, let's do the twitching again. And this rod and this setup looks so great with the red line. I'm very happy that I can finally fish with it, but I think for the very heavy fish, we need to wait for the Mississippi Lake. That's what I'm thinking. Alright, come on, fish. Come on. I need to go a little bit backwards, I think. I think that the fish are under me, but I cannot reach them because my lure is already going to the surface. So let's go a little bit back. Okay. Maybe this is better. Okay, let's try it again. Can I go all the way to the bottom? Yeah, this is better. This is now we are going to get it. Check this. We are going to get it. I'm sure of it. Stop and go. Yeah. Oh, it was a bite. But I got 6-0 hook on. Sometimes a normal lake trout cannot grab this hook because it's a little bit too big. Can we? Yeah. Okay, we got it. Did you guys saw it? So there was a check this. Lake trout, just like that. Trophy. 5 seconds. Pan fishing. So I like it a lot. The new screen is looks very good too. So yeah, that's it guys. I'm going to end this video. The next video I'm going to make it now right away because I'm totally full with Red Bull and all that other stuff. I'm going to show you guys the new missions and I'm going to show you guys the new competition. Because you can make your own competition. But that was it for this video. Thanks for watching. Have fun. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.